Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. So today we are going to discuss the chapter number 2 of civics class 9. What is democracy and why democracy? Let's begin with the topic democracy. First of all, I will tell you the meaning of democracy. What is democracy? As you have studied in the 6th standard also, democracy is the form of government by which people elect their own rulers or they choose their own representatives. See, in 6th standard, you have done the 3 or 4 forms of government: monarchy, dictatorship or democracy. Now in this chapter, we are going to discuss the following topics. Let's see. These are some of the topics which we are going to discuss in this chapter: the stories of democracy, difference between democratic and non-democratic countries, democracy and its features, merits and demerits of democracy, why democracy is considered as the best form of government, and what are the reasons for this. Next, these are some of the countries and the different aspects which they are, their government is following. First is Myanmar, army rule is there. Child, Nepal. In Nepal, there is a monarchy. In Pakistan, Parvez Musharraf is ruling. In Poland, there is USSR and USA. In China, there is only one party, because in China, we have only one party system. But in India, we have multi-party systems. In Mexico, there is PRI, that is Institutional Revolutionary Party. And in Zimbabwe, there is a Mugabe, who is the president. So, what is the meaning? The word democracy is derived from the Greek word demos and kratia. Demos means people and power means, the kratia means rule. It is a form of government in which rulers are elected by the people. Democracy means when all the citizens are having the rights to take part in the decision making, or they have the right to take the decisions, they have the right to participate in the election process, they have the right to express their own views and opinions, they have the right to correct their own mistakes. So next, talk about the this is the quote, or this is the lines given by the Abraham Lincoln: democracy is the form of government by the people, for the people and of the people. Next comes to what are the features of democracy. Features means characteristics. First is, it is based on the free and fair elections. That means in India, we are having the free and fair elections in every 5 years. Each citizen must have one value and one vote contains one value. It is based on the fundamental principles of economic, social and political equality. This is the main important aspect of democracy. What are the merits of democracy? See, democracy is the accountable form of government. It is most responsive, accountable and legitimate form of government. That means, how it is responsible? Responsible means it is responding to the needs of its citizens. It is responding to the wishes of the citizens of the country. That is why it is more accountable form of government. Second is, it improves the quality of decision making, because it is giving, democracy is giving the chance to each of its citizens. It enhances the dignity of citizens. Whenever we are giving rights to it to the citizens, that means it is enhancing the respect, or it is giving the respect to all its citizens. It provides a method to deal with the differences and conflicts. That means we are giving the chance to the citizens to deal with the differences, how we can deal our the conflicts, whatever differences are arising. Now, why democracy is considered as the best form of government? As I have already told you, it gives the chance to people to correct their mistakes. People have the right to express their own views and opinions. They can protest and form trade unions. They have given the chance to discuss the issues and share their problems. And democracy also gives equal rights to all its citizens. Very important. See, now in this chapter, there are 2 or 3 countries and they have